Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Today we are going to learn another type of fraction. See, in the previous chapter fraction we have seen many fractions, many types of fractions. We have done operations on fraction, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, so here when any fraction has denominator, see, 4 upon 10 or 25 upon 100, 6 upon 1000, so like this fraction, see, like this fractions having the denominator 10, 100, 1000, we have seen fraction like this 4 upon 5 or 7 upon 12, having denominator 5 other than 10, 100 or 1000. So see, if the fraction like this, fraction having denominators 10, 100 and 1000, 10,000 and lakh, that is having denominator like this 10, 100, 1000, multiples of 10, and then 1000, 10,000, 1 lakh, 10 lakh, So like these fractions having denominators in the form of multiples of 10, these fractions can be written in another way also, The fractions having denominators 10, 100, 1000 can be written in another way. That way is called decimal fraction. Decimal fraction, Last year we have learned, again we will revise this. So when denominator is 100 or 1000, how to convert this fraction into decimal fraction, that we will learn. Before that, we will take some basic information about it. Now see, here this is the strip. This is one strip. This one strip is divided into 10 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. 10 equal parts. Consider they are 10 equal parts, and out of 10 equal parts, one part is shaded. So how can you write fraction for this? The fraction for this can be total parts are 10, that will be written in the denominator, and out of 10 equal parts, one part is shaded, that is 1 upon 10, means what? Out of this one strip, this is one whole strip, and that strip is divided into 10 equal parts, and out of 10 equal parts, one part is shaded. So the fraction we have got 1 upon 10, that is 1/10. 1/10. So this 1 upon 10 can be written. This is called fractional form. This 1 upon 10 can be written in another way. How? See, 1 upon 10 is equal to 0.1. 0.1. Why 0.1? Because this was one strip, but the fraction is written, we have to write fraction for shaded part. Shaded part is one part out of 10, means it is not complete strip. So 0 and 0.1. 1 means this part, one part. One strip here, the shaded part, we have to write fraction for shaded part, it is part of that one strip, means it is not complete strip. So the strip is 0. 0.1 is one part of this strip is shaded. So 0.1. That is 1 out of 10 is same as 0.1. See here also there is one strip, it is divided into 10 equal parts, and out of 10 equal parts, 4 parts are shaded. How many parts are shaded? 4 parts. So this 4 upon 10 can be written in another way. How? How it can be written in another way? 0.4. 0.4. See here, there is one more strip, it is also divided into 10 equal parts, and out of 10, how many parts are shaded? 7. 7/10. And 7/10 can be written in another way? 0.7. 0.7. Means 7 parts of this one strip is shaded, not whole strip is shaded. If whole strip would have shaded, that is 10 out of 10, then there would be 1. 1.0. But here whole strip is not shaded, just 7 parts of this one strip is shaded, so it is 0.7. Now observe this pattern, 1 upon 10 means 0.1, 4 upon 10 means 0.4, 7 upon 10 means 0.7. Okay, observe this pattern. How to read this? This point is given, no? Between 0 and 4, between 0 and 7, between 0 and 1. It is called decimal point. It is called decimal point. Decimal point, okay? And how to read this? 0.1, 0.4, this way. 0.1, here 0.4. Here 0.7. In this way we can read this. Okay, understood? Now see here. Not need to write it, just pay, watch this carefully and understand this pattern. So if there is any number, 9 upon 10, 8 upon 10, 6 upon 10, having denominator 10, can be written in the decimal form. How to write this into the decimal form? 9 upon 10 can be written as 0.9, 8 upon 10 can be written as 0.8, 6 upon 10 can be written as 0.6, okay? And how to read this? 0.9, 0.8, 0.6. This is called decimal. This is called decimal fraction. Okay, the decimal form of 9 upon 10, this fractional number. Decimal form of these common fractions. Okay. Let us solve the exercise or practice based on this concept. It's very easy. These are basic concepts. So, immediately we will solve the exercise. See here. Let us practice 6.1. Write this practice 6.1 in your textbook, notebook, okay? Write in notebook because we have to write there some sentences, okay? So practice 6.1, solve in the notebook. See the first question, how will you read the following? First question is, how will you read the following? 0.1, then there is 0.4, then there is 0.6. Okay, see how can you read this? The question is how can you read this? So I have shown you how to read this 0.1. So let's write 0.1. In spelling only you could write, huh? 0.4, then 0.7, 0.9. In this way we can read this, okay? See question number 2. Express the following as a decimal. They have given fraction 2 upon 10, 3 upon 10, 7 upon 10, 5 upon 10. Okay. And we have to express this as a decimal. Means they have given here in the form of common fraction, which we have seen in the earlier chapter, previous chapter. Common fraction having numerator and denominator. Okay, this we can convert into decimal as we have seen before this. Okay, so 2 upon 10 can be written as 0.2. Okay, 3 upon 10 can be written as 0.3. 7 upon 10 can be written as 0.7. And 5 upon 10 can be written as 0.5. Okay, in this we can write. Next, question number 3. express the following as a decimal. See, now they have given fraction, but they have given in the form of fractional number, means in spelling. 7, 10. Seven tens, nine tens. We will solve these two only. Remaining two you solve. Okay, solve as a homework. Now see, 7 tens. This is given in fractional number, that is number name of that fraction. Okay, so 7 tens means 7/10. Again, we got in the common fraction 7/10. So 7/10. We have to write in the decimal fraction, okay? So 7/10 means 0.7. Okay, 9 tens means 9/10. That is in decimal 0.9. Is that it easy? Yeah. So remaining to solve by yourself, okay? Then question 4. Write the fraction for each of the following decimal. Question 4, write here, and in that A1 is 0.3, B 0.8, C 0.1, and D 0.9. Okay, so these are decimal numbers or decimals, and these decimals we have to write into fraction. Means here fractions we converted into decimal, opposite of that decimals we have to convert into again fraction. Okay, so this 0.3, now see here, it is denominator is 10 here. This in this concept where we have denominator 10 only, so it is very easy. But when all the concepts will come together, how to understand whether there is denominator 10 or 100 or 1000? How to understand? See, now with this pattern, I think you have come to know that when there is denominator 10, that is denominator 10 has 10, so after decimal point, see, there is one digit, as 10 is there in the denominator. Similarly here, see how to understand, after decimal point, there is only one digit. After decimal point, we know that 0.3 means 3/10, we know, but how to understand, how to keep it in mind? How to keep it in mind, you know, after decimal point, there is one digit. So, in the denominator, right, after 1, write 10, and this 3, write out 3/10, okay? So, here also 0.1 is 1/10. 0.8, only one digit after decimal point, so after 1, 10, and 8 out, 0.8. Here 9/10. Okay, so in this way we have to write the decimal numbers for the common fraction having denominator 10. In this way we can write decimal numbers having for the common fractions having denominator 10. Understood? Now pause this video and write this in your notebook. So just now we have converted common fractions into decimal, okay? But if there will be mixed fraction, see in this way, 2 whole 1/3, 1 by 10, 4 whole 7/10, 6 whole 5/10. So if it would be like this mixed fraction, then how to write these fractions into decimal? Because 2 whole means here, see in previous concept, we draw only one strip, and one strip was divided into 10 equal parts, and suppose some parts were shaded. So such in this one strip, 2 parts were shaded, means not complete, one whole strip was not shaded. So in that case, you wrote 2/10, that is 0.2. But here if you see, 2 whole 1/10, what is meaning of this? 2 whole means 2 complete strips are shaded. 2 complete strips are shaded, okay, and third one strip is divided into 10 equal parts, and out of 10 1 is shaded, okay. So in that case, how to write decimal fraction, decimal numbers for this 2 whole 1 upon 10? What to do, you know? As I told you in the previous concept, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 means 0 was indicating that not a single strip is shaded completely, but here 2 strips are shaded completely. Okay, so that 2 can be written before decimal point and after 2 put decimal point. Here there is decimal point before decimal point. In previous concept there was 0 because not a single strip was shaded completely. Okay, but here 2 whole indicates that 2 strips are shaded completely. 2 strips are shaded completely. So 2.1 upon 10 means third strip is divided into 10 equal parts and out of 10 equal parts 1 is shaded. So here you write 1 upon 10, how to write 0.1, that is 2 is already there, 2.1. Understood? 2.1. Okay. Next is, so in this way 4 whole 7 upon 10 will be written as 4.7. Okay, 4.7. 6 whole 5 upon 10 will be written as 6.5. Understood? So in this way we can write the fractional number greater than 1. Means these fractions are greater than 1. There is 2 whole, complete 2, complete 4, complete 6, and next figure is divided into 10 equal parts and 5 are shaded. So 6 whole means 6 point. Whole part should be written before point and fractional part should be written after point. Okay, so 6.5. Now pay attention here in exercise practice 6.2. You will come to know more about this concept. See the first question in practice 6.2. You can open your textbook. 1. How will you read the following? 4.2, 3.5. Okay, these 4 decimals are given and we have to write how can we read this. So 4.2, how to read this? 4.2. Be habitual with the reading. 4.2, that is 4. Point, don't say .4.2, no, 4.2. This 3.5. This 8.7. Correct? This 9.3. Okay, in this way we can read. See the second question. See, I have space here, so I am writing second question here, but you write below this question, okay, in your notebook. Question 2. Express the following as decimals. Express the following as decimals. They have given here mixed fraction. We have to express them as a decimal, as we have seen before this. See, 12 whole 1 by 10, how to write into the decimal. 12 whole, so whole part write first and after it put decimal point. And 1 by 10, we know how to write. 0.1 means 12.1. Then 21 whole 4 upon 10, that is 21.4. 43 whole 6 upon 10, that is 43.6. 1 whole 3 upon 10, so it can be written as 1.3. 3 upon 10 can be written as 0.3. Okay, in this way. Is it difficult? No. Question 3. express these decimals as fractions or mixed fractions. So 2.7, 4.8, 27.9, 4.7. Okay. See here, 2.7. So 2. The number number before decimal point it is whole part. So it can be written as 2 whole. 0.7 means 7/10. Understood? 4.8 means 4 whole. 0.8 means 8/10. 27.9, that is 27 whole, 9/10. And 4.7 means 4 whole, 7/10. Whole. 4 whole means WHOLE, whole. Complete. 4 complete and 0.7 is 7/10. 7 out of 10. Understood? So in this way we can convert proper fractions or common fractions into decimal having denominator 10. Tomorrow we will see how to convert common fractions having denominator 100 into decimal. This keep it in mind. Okay, whenever there is upon 10, after decimal point there is one digit only. See everywhere. When there is upon 10, denominator is 10. While converting into decimal fraction, after decimal point there is only one digit all the time. Keep that in mind. Okay. So I hope you understood this. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask. So till then, thank you and have a nice day.